I'm gonna show you the ultimate tic-tac-toe. Just to remind you that only tic-tac-toe games look something like this and proceed like this. I don't think there's room for strategies and game plan in such a small game, and games are usually tied and becomes very, very boring. And thus, I'll show you the new ultimate tic-tac-toe. It's got 9 tic-tac-toe balls. You'll understand as I proceed. But before I start proceeding, I'll explain the rules. I'll just enter the player names so it becomes easier to explain. I'll go with Harry and Ron. So this is the main screen. There's some rules regarding the movement and marking of X and O. Suppose Harry marks X in the central box of this board, so the next player, that is Ron, would have to choose the central board of the game, that's the highlighted part. He can mark O anywhere in this highlighted board, but he has to stick to this board. Now Ron decides to mark O on the top right box of this board, and so Harry would have to choose the top right board of the game. And Harry marks X in the central box, then Ron would have to choose the central board of the game, and so on. The board gets highlighted every time someone marks an X or O. Now Ron can see an opportunity to win this board, so he marks his O here and wins the board. Now the board will be treated as O, but so the software prefers green for O. The game involves strategy and game plan. Players have to think to which board they want to send the opponent, and so it becomes quite challenging and very, very different from the normal tic-tac-toe game, which is short and boring. Harry can see an opportunity to win the board, and so he does. Like I put the O over there, I would put X like this over here. But software had designated blue color for the X, and it looks quite clean like this. You must have noticed that all the boards have become highlighted. That's very important. It's because Harry gave Ron an advantage. At last turn, Harry marked central box, so Ron will have to go to the central board. But it has already been solved, so all the boards are open for Ron. Like this, and Ron can mark anywhere. He marks O there. And so the game continues. It becomes very necessary to see that you don't send your opponent to the solved board, because you don't want to give your opponent advantage so that he can mark his X and O anywhere in this board. See how freely they are giving upper advantage to others, and very bad. You can see this board is tied, so it will count for both X and O. Remember how we put X and O over there? Here we will put X and O together because the board has been tied. But soccer prefers a red color for the tied board, so and it looks very clean like that. I guess if we click on some other board where we aren't supposed to mark, it will give a warning and won't let you mark anywhere. Harry wins, and an X here, and Harry wins this board too. At this point I would show you all the markings because it's very important. You can see there are 3 X in a line in the bottom row, although there's an O in the tied board, but still there are 3 X in line like this. And so X, that is Harry, wins the game because he's got 3 X in line. Now the game is won. Everything is disabled and you can start a new game by resetting the game. If you're a Harry Potter fan like me, believe me, you want to check out the new Ultimate Tic-Tac-Toe with Hermione version. It's awesome and it's really, really cool. You can find all the download links of the softwares in the video description, the new Ultimate Tic-Tac-Toe as well. If you like the video, do give it a like, download the software, and I'll be waiting for a response and other specifications you want to add.